Morning. Welcome to Web Digital webinar series. So we are today we are going to discuss about topics like latest updates in our portal for reconciliation and GSTR 1 and EV bill reconciliation and GSTR 9. So let us start with the reconciliation first. So in reconciliation, there are steps which we need to do first. First, we need to upload GSTR 2 data for the means which we have purchase data, the purchase register, and we have to download GSTR 2A from the government portal. So I'll show you how to upload the data and how to download the GSTR 2A. So here we have the template. In download documents, we have the template of GSTR 2 ITC and ITC reversal template. You can fill the data from your purchase register. Here, so what all the doc, as of now, reconciliation is for only B2B. So B2B and CDNR. So you can select only B2B. So whenever you are selecting such document type, automatically for that row, some rows will be highlighted, those which are mandatory to fill up. So here, if I select B2B, GSTN number, period, supplier GSTN, invoice number, invoice date, invoice type, and the rate, taxable value, IGST, CGST, SGST, cess amount, and invoice value plus a supply and reverse charge. So these are the mandatory. So you can give the option whether IT for 3B purpose, you can give the option for IT, whether it is eligible or ineligible. If it is eligible, what is the type of invoice, input purchase or capital purchase or input service, or not, it is not eligible also we can give. So the amounts which are same way, wherever you have given what amount is eligible, you can give there. And suppose if you select CDNR, then automatically the color will be changed. So here you need to give note number and note date also. Note type, what is, whether it is credit or debit, note number, note date, reason, and whether it is pre-GST or post-GST. So, and you can give B2BUR also. It will be useful for 3B purpose. B2BUR, IMPS, IMPC, NIL, and HSN summary, ITC reversal also. So after filling this data, you need to save it as CSV, comma delimited file. So in Excel, you can find out here CSV, comma delimited, and you need to save the data. And so after creating the file, you need to go to GSTR CSV upload. Here you can find out GSTR 2, select the GSTR 2 and template, web template, and choose the file and import the data. So here you will get all records and process records and error records. You can download the error records and correct in the same file, and you can upload the same file. Then you need to click on here, view summary. The entire summary will be displayed here. After clicking on view summary, then you will get the data which is imported till now. See, this is the data. So after that, you need to click on GSTR upload. Then the data will go into our portal. Now, so we have uploaded GSTR 2 data. Now we need to download GSTR 2A. Here we have given option in GSTR downloads. You need to click on GSTR 2A download. Then you need to select GSTN number. It can ask OTP. Then from and to period, we have given a limitation of 18 months. So up to 18 months you can download. So I can see for 7/2017 to 3/2018. So up to 18 months at a single shot, you can download all the actions also. See, here we have given the option all. So automatically system will download. And if you want, you can export it also. Then, so now GSTR 2A is also downloaded. Now if system automatically will do some part of reconciliation. So we can go to reconciliation and we can select the GST number. Here we have given two options, either period wise reconciliation or invoice wise and invoice date wise reconciliation. Like period wise, may like suppose if you wanted to do from July to March 2018, whatever the dates, whatever the amount. So if you select period, so 07/2017 to, so here also please select less than or equal to 18 months. We have a limitation till 18 months. So I'm taking only 17/18 reconciliation. So here view details. So these are the which is GSTR 2A and 2 data. So this is the reconciliation summary dashboard. Reconciliation dashboard. So here we can get six tables. First one is matched invoices, mismatch invoices. Matched invoices means the supplier who has uploaded is exactly matching with your invoices. So those are coming into matched invoices. Here we can have settings for 1 rupee difference, 5 rupees difference, 10 rupees difference. You can in settings you can adjust that, and automatically those differences, if in tax amounts if you have 1 rupee difference, then automatically it will come to matched invoices. Then mismatched invoices. Mismatched invoices means everything is matched but except tax amounts. So suppose you have uploaded the same invoice and the supplier has also uploaded, but both are uploaded with the different values. So those invoices will come into mismatched invoices. And now missing invoice in supplier's data, missing invoice in my data. So missing invoice in supplier data means you have uploaded the invoice but supplier has not uploaded. And missing invoice in my data means supplier has uploaded but you have not uploaded. There is one more case, both can have uploaded the invoices but with the different invoice numbers. Suppose he has uploaded GST/23 but you have uploaded GST 23. So those kind of invoices also will be coming into missing invoices. For that we have given one option. Before that I'll tell you one more, like hold invoices. Suppose if you wanted that invoice into next month, suppose if you don't want to reconcile that invoice in this month, so you wanted to hold it for next month, so you can hold those invoices, and those all hold invoices will come here. And whenever you are entering into next month, you can come to hold invoices and you can select all, and you can click on unhold, then automatically those hold invoices will go into next month reconciliation. So it will come part of reconciliation for the next month. And suppose whatever accepted invoices, whatever modified, rejected, hold invoices will shown here. So whatever rejected and modified invoices, if you wanted to reset it, so we have given an option. So suppose you have done wrong thing in reconciliation, invoice data correction or something, so you can get it back. Suppose if you click on invoice and if you select the invoice and click on reset, automatically that invoice will go to the original places. Like GSTR2 invoice will go to missing, and GSTR2A invoice will go to here. Now for this reconciliation part, like invoice numbers mismatch, we have given one option, invoice data correction. So here invoice data correction, we have given filter type, match invoice, invoice number, match invoice, invoice date, and invoice value, all invoices. So match invoices, invoice number means if you have any invoice, suppose supplier has uploaded with the invoice number GST/23, you have uploaded GST 23, those invoices will come part of it, and you can select all, you can accept from 2A. Whatever is available in 2A, so that particular invoice which is related that invoice number to other on same date, not on other dates also. So you can blindly accept those invoices. And matched invoices, invoice date. Invoice date means suppose everything is matched except invoice date. Suppose you have given invoice date as 1st January 2018, but they have given 3rd January 2018. So you can, those also you can blindly accept from GSTR 2A. Now, so after doing this, if you go to reconciliation, then you will find out the final reconciliation dashboard. So if you wanted to take in Excel, then you can export it. That file will download in Excel. After that, you can see what and all are there available, how it will be. I will show you just a minute. Reconciliation log. So this is the activity log summary. So missing in two data, missing in two A data. These are the all invoices. In first one activity type, you can find out, and you can find source data GSTR 2 and 2A. Here missing in GSTR 2A, you can find out, and missing in GSTR 2 data, in you can find out. Then, so this way you can, you will get the data in Excel. So after that, suppose if you wanted to do supplier wise, so we have given that option also in here, reconciliation summary. Here in filter type, you can select supplier wise summary. So here you will get all GSTN, your GST number and supplier GST number. So you can export it and you can see how much is available for this customer. Suppose if we take first one, JPF MetaCash Private Limited. So what is the GSTR 2 value and GSTR 2A value? See, GSTR 2 tax amount is 9,62,930, but in 2A 7,72,299. So what is the difference? So for that customer, the total tax difference is 1,90,130. Out of total tax difference, this only customer having 13% of difference. So if you wanted to work on that customer, so before that, see here you will get the option to go to that page, but here you will not get, because before that you need to update the supplier name. So the supplier name you can update in the supplier management, or you can upload with CSV in supplier management itself with the supplier name, email ID, mobile number also. So after that, you can click, if you click on this, automatically only for that supplier, the reconciliation page will open. See, supplier name and supplier gestion, automatically it will come. So 28 invoices in missing in GS supplier data, 26 invoices in missing in my data. So this is the reconciliation summary for particular supplier. This also you can export. Suppose if you wanted to send a mail to that customer saying that these are the missing invoices, then we have given one option, supply trigger. For using supply trigger, which you need to do is, in supplier management, you need to update all your suppliers' mail ID and phone number. So if at least mail ID will be compulsory. So if you give mail ID, if I click on supply trigger, then automatically one mail will go to that supplier email ID. How it will be, I'll show you. It will come from noreply@webdigital.com. So we, on behalf of Web Sandbox, that means your company name will come, having the GSTN number, which GSTN you are using, and would like to inform you that we have observed the following discrepancies of suppliers made or services provided to them. Please find the reconciliation summary for supplier having GSTN number. So this is supplier GSTN. So if they click on this, automatically one zip file they can download. So they can, one zip file will open, and in that, what all the Excel files, suppose what all the actions which are available here, what all the data which is available here, it will go to them. Then they can see and they can contact you for reconciliation, next phase of reconciliation. So this way you can do individual supplier wise reconciliation also. So here, so we can come back to the reconciliation summary again. So this way you can download. So you can download export. So you can export into Excel this file, this one, and you can see what and all is available, who all are upload exactly. So if you see this Excel file, so if you see tax difference, so these people are uploaded exactly. So this person 27,900,56,88,134. So remaining people only you can go for reconciliation. So this is the advantage while doing supplier wise. And now you can see only for B2B export and only for CDNR. And now, see, there are many questions around how amendment reconciliation will do. So we have given one option that we have internally taken that option, saying that whenever you are downloading amendments, automatically it will search those invoices with the original invoice details with the CTN. It will search in GSTR 2A original data. If it is there, then automatically it will replace the latest data. And if it is not there, it will insert into GSTR 2A. So basically, whatever you are getting into reconciliation, it will combine the GSTR 2A normal data and amendment data. So amendments will automatically will come directly to GSTR 2A whenever you download it. So no need to worry about amendments. It will also have part of reconciliation. Now, so we have GSTR 6 reconciliation also in the same way, but month-wise. Now, see, this is the complete process of reconciliation. So supplier trigger, we have the option. And if you wanted to do reset everything, suppose you thought that everything is gone wrong, we need to do reconciliation again. So you can reset it and entire thing will go back and all the invoices, GSTR 2 data will go to import page and all GSTR 2 data will come into missing in my data. So then you can delete the data or you can download again or you can upload again, whatever you want, you can do that. So we have given from and to up to 18 months reconciliation at a time and supplier name and supplier GSTN with the supplier GSTN itself. So whoever having doubts, you can write in chat box or you can send a mail as also. You can reply to that. And this is the reconciliation first topic. GSTR 2 and 2A reconciliation. So now second topic, GSTR 1 and e-way bill reconciliation. Here you can see e-way bill options. So all the options will be available, generate e-way bill, bulk upload, e-way bill list, view and print, consolidated e-way bill list, update vehicle number, update transfer. So in that last option will be reconciliation. You can select the GSTN number. So this GSTR 1 and e-way bill reconciliation will be based on the data which is uploaded through web and e-way bill generated through web digital only. It is not related to government portal. Whatever is uploaded in NIC portal will not count, will not be a part of it. So whoever uploaded in web digital portal, that reconciliation will be happen. So here you can give the from and to date. So I have given from 1/12/2018 to 19/3/2019. So here you will get missing e-way bills in B2B, B2CL, export, CDNR and CDNUR and missing e-way bills in B2CS. So you can export it. Whatever is matched will not come here. Only whatever is missing. That means e-way bills which are missing for the invoice numbers will come here. So these are the document numbers which are missing. E-way bills in B2B, B2CL, export, CDNR and CDNUR and here e-way bills missing in B2CS. So you can export it into Excel and you can take further action. So this is GSTR 1 and e-way bill reconciliation. And now third is GSTR 9 report. So GSTR 9 APIs has been released. So we are working on that. Soon it will be available through API. So as of now, whatever GSTR 1 and GSTR 3B and GSTR 2A is available in our portal or in government portal also. We are taking that. We are converting that into GSTR 9 format and we are giving the exact report. So what you have to do before that, you need to go to GSTR 2A and download GSTR 2A and GSTR 3B download for entire period and GSTR 1 download and GSTR 1 download. So if you download these three, automatically your GSTR 9 report will be ready and you can select the GSTN and select the financial year 17-18 and export it. Automatically it will come into format, whatever is required format. So this is the GSTR 9 report. Soon we are going to give APIs also. So online, through online platform. So obviously it will be available very, very soon actually. So this is the GSTR 9 report. And this is the third part. So if you have any queries relating to these three topics, you can give your question in chat box. We can answer those or you can send us a mail also. So So these are the topics. So thank you for your time. So if you have any queries, you can send us email to info@webdigital.com. Thank you guys. Thank you for your time. Sure.